Katic with a cracker.
Everyone, welcome back to the United Star. We've just drawn 1-1 with West Ham and we are in third place momentarily before Chelsea plays Liverpool. We have Vidur with us to rate the players today. So Vidur, let's get straight into it. How did you rate David De Gea?
To begin with, I mean, you know, the game, he came off a very, very rough game against Chelsea and today you could see that he was sweating. You know, he was very nervous and when, as a keeper, you're nervous, you tend to, you know, it's just that you tend to look at everything. You don't want to make mistakes. But considering that, he did what any keeper would today, you know, did his job, made 2-3 good saves. So, yeah, I mean, considering that, I'd give him 7.8.
Yeah. Okay. I think I'd give him a 6. I don't think he had much to do. But let's move on to the right back, Fosu Mensah.
Fosu Mensah, I mean, again, you know, like, hasn't played much. Hasn't done a lot, just like, you know, he could do much more. Like, he conceded that yellow card unnecessarily and, in fact, missed a chance as well. I mean, he could have done better, but then again, he's pretty much inexperienced and the fact that he somehow did a good, like, he did a good job. He didn't do anything bad. So, yes, I'd give him 7 today.
Okay. What maybe about...
Not too much.
Okay. What about Victor Lindelof?
Lindelof, very shaky. I did not like him. You know, in fact, in air, he just looks like he's very shaky. And the fact that United has, like, are continuously playing from behind and giving Lindelof the ball, like, it just seems shaky. You know, it doesn't seem like it's a confident game. It just seems like, you know, like, at the moment you press, you, there's more likely you'll give the ball to the opponent. So, it's wrong. So, yeah, I'd give him, it's, he didn't play well today. He was very shaky. So, I'd definitely give him something like, 5.5, maybe.
Okay. What about Frigion Wheels, yeah. Harry Maguire? I thought he was pretty good today, pretty decent, pretty solid.
I mean, I personally feel that he could have done better. You know, it's just that, like, where he should be playing, like, okay, fine. He's defensively, he was doing his job. But, like, you know, when it comes to distribution, he could have done a much better job. You know, when he could see open passes, he was choosing to play the simpler pass. I mean, fine. I mean, I get it. You're not Bruno Fernandes. But the thing is that, okay, if you see a player open, if you see him running in there, at least give it a shot. Put the ball in. You know, why are you afraid of making mistakes? Like, it's a long ball. It's not that a lot of bad things can't happen from it. So, yeah, give it a shot. But then again, he did his defensive duty as well. So, yes, I would give him a 7 as well.
Okay.
7.5.
And what about Brandon Williams? Brandon Williams defensively was almost non-existent today almost.
I mean, Brandon Williams was there, but I'd say that, like, you know, he just seems very, like, he seems very low confident. Like, you know, it didn't seem like he's his confident self. I felt that he could have done better, definitely. So, yeah, considering that and considering loose balls being played by him and, you know, unnecessary pass decisions being made by him, yeah, I'd give him a 6.5. He could definitely have done better.
Okay. Yeah. And what about Nemanja Matic?
Matic was doing his job. You know, Matic, I felt that Matic was one of the players which, if not for today, we could easily lose the game. You know, because Matic was doing his defensive duties. He was, basically, he's a player in form, you know, and with experience on his side, he was doing what an experienced player should be. He was making sure that he's, you know, doing his role well, and he was. So, yes, I'd give him a 7.5. Definitely.
Mm-hmm. And what about Pogba at fault for the first goal? How did you rate his performance?
Looks like Pogba was playing volleyball inside his own half. You know, inside his own D. I mean, I get it. Maybe definitely lapse of concentration, which led to that, you know, because had he been concentrating on the ball, he definitely wouldn't have applied his hands. And what it was a reflex action. But it's just that he was not concentrating on it. That's why that happened. Again, not defending him on that. So, yeah, considering that, I mean, he looked a little down, but he didn't look too sharp. You know, not playing those long balls that, you know, he does. Because a game like this needed long balls. Game like this needed that to get behind penetration, but it didn't happen today. So yeah, I'd give him a 6.5 today.
Okay. Yep. I thought it was more like a 4 kind of a performance, but what about Bruno Fernandes?
Bruno he looks tired, you know. He looks very jaded. He looks very like, you know, okay, yeah, he's been playing. But the thing is that if you over, he seems overexhausted. He seems burned out. I guess after, he's just running on fumes right now. And I guess he needs good rest before the Leicester game because, yeah, he seems tired, you know, tired passing, not too much creativity, you know, like, again, he's going to the sides. Like, we need a player who can control the center. Nobody was, there was many plays where, you know, I felt he could have been in the center, but he wasn't. So that was something that he could have done better. But yeah, considering that and like loose balls being played today, not the best game of Bruno. So yes, I'd give him a 6 today.
Okay.
6.5.
What about our goal scorer in Mason Greenwood?
Greenwood was one of the sharp players today, I felt. I mean, again, not too much work rate, but then again, he was making it count when he was forward, you know, cutting in, putting in the, like, you know, made many, you know, cutback passes as well, cutting in, and he got the goal, obviously, great finish, you know. Seems like a very confident kid, and I really like his style of play. So, yes, for me, like, if I were to decide, like, in the United team, the best player in the United team, you know, so I'd give him an 8 today.
Okay.
Because I felt he did pretty well.
What about Tony Martial?
Martial was good. You know, Martial was good. He looked hungry. It's just that, like, he didn't get the service as required. And considering the fact that West Ham playing about 6 players in their own box, so it was very hard for him to, you know, get through those. But yeah, that 1-2 play, his assist to Greenwood, that 1-2 play between him and Greenwood, great stuff, you know, good stuff. So yeah, I felt that I'd give him a 7.8 today.
Okay. And finally, to round off the team, Marcus Rashford.
Rashford didn't look like, again, he also looks tired, you know, he looks jaded. He did not seem his sharp self, you know, very casual, like, you know, poor passing, like some of the passes he made was well, but like some passes were like, you know, it didn't feel like, you know, it was the right pass. Like, we looking at the screen could tell that it's not the right pass to play, you know. So, but yeah, obviously the feel is different, but still, considering the level that he's playing, he should be doing much better. And considering the where he is in the season, they should be putting their heart on it. It just looked like they were absent, right? They weren't there exactly. And so wasn't Rashford. So yeah, he could have done much better. So considering that, I'd give him a 6 today. Mm-hmm. Nothing great.
And finally, just to wrap up things with Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, do you think that the team came out with enough intensity? And since West Ham were playing, as you said, with 6 players in the box, do you think we had enough ideas to change that?
See, the thing is that I feel that from the beginning tactic of, you know, like playing the, like on a goal kick, starting from behind, that was not working. It didn't work against Chelsea. You know, that high pressing got to us. And that's what was happening again today in the initial half. You know, and I felt that he was somewhere being a little bit, you know, he could have done a managerially a better job, because you could see in pockets of play that, you know, West Ham had like a few players completely unmarked. They could, on a bad day, they could have got the ball and easily scored. No problems. You know, no hassles. And there were many occasions when the West Ham attackers were 2-on-1 with the United defender. So that is some tactical problems he's facing. And with 6 players in the box, see, that's what most teams play. You know, in the like mid-level and, you know, lower-table teams play. So that's nothing new. But yeah, if you play with the same tactic every game, they're bound to study you. You know, they're bound to adapt. So he needs to change his tactics a little bit, because it's the same tactic. It's this one-trick pony won't work. And it's not working now. And with Leicester will come out hungry. Next game is huge. Next game, next season can be decided in a matter of minutes, you know. So, next game, they need to change a little, tweak the tactics a little bit, and need to come out much, much more hungry than what they were today. I mean, draw's good, but win would have been much better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I felt with Ole, I'd rate his tactics 5.5. Because I felt he could have done much better with those tactics.
I kind of agree. I think with tactics and as well with just the general hunger he should have brought the team on with, he didn't do it. So thanks, Vidur, for joining us. A very disappointing result. More than that, another disappointing performance. And it's sort of getting into that same old sort of rut that we're not being able to get out of now. So let's see what happens against Leicester. Subscribe to the channel, guys, and like the video. We'll see you all soon.